Okay, gyroscope and ES model 332 tachometer. It's a laser tachometer and it registers on this retroreflective tape. When I hit the measure button, it's supposed to receive a signal off of there. And when it's not moving, the signal is kind of, well, random. So, spin it up with the Dremel. Got it up to 13K, that's pretty good. And the decay rate is substantial. And the reading is, well, I'm jumping about a bit. It pretty much has to hit the retroreflective tape to work. Spin it up again and see if I get anything repeatable. So I gotta watch out for spurious readings. But it looks like 1300 RPM is about where I get it up to. And yeah, the spin decays very quickly. Show you the setup. This bar is used for an experiment to basically measure the moment of inertia of the discs. The idea is you wrap a string around here and you take a weight, let it fall to the ground, accelerating the wheel, and there's some math given to allow you to compute the moment of inertia of the wheel. See how fast it's going now. Looks like I definitely I think the best I'll be able to do is do precession measurements within a bracket of about 100 RPM. Supposed to work from up to, I think, 6 feet away. Not that that's a huge deal. Now, another challenge to improve the consistency of the experiment is setting up a yoke so that when I have the counterweights and this is gone and I'm bouncing a laser off of this mirror to measure the precession rate, is when I start this up, I need this to be rock steady, like it is when this is in place. But the thing is, this is not quick release at all. I need a yoke that attaches from here to around here that can swing out of the way quickly after revving up the flywheel and give me a nice steady starting point. And I'll still use that refrigerator. And I'll measure, I'll have a yardstick on it, and I'll measure with a kite string. I'll measure to each end of the each end of the yardstick from the center point, and I'll be able to work out the angle subtended by the yardstick, which will allow me to get a very good measurement of precession rate using a video camera to see how quickly the laser traverses the yardstick. This is my laser tachometer test. And there's one of my assistants. Okay, 11 minutes is long enough.